Einstein's Relativity, The Special Theory and the General Theory. Chapter 2, The Frame of Reference. Relying on the physical interpretation of the geometrical concepts such as distance, as explained in the previous chapter, we can now determine the physical distance between two points on a rigid body in practice, e.g. through measurements. For this purpose, we need a rigid rod with a fixed length, interval s, that we can repeatedly use as a standard measuring stick. If A and B are two points on a rigid body, then a line, or more precisely straight line, connecting these two points can be constructed according to the laws of Euclidean geometry. Starting from one point A then, we can remove the interval s along this straight line as many times as necessary until we get to the other point B. The number of the removal operations performed is the numerical measure of the total distance AB. This is the basis of all measurement of physical length. Any spatial description of the location of an event or of an object boils down to specifying the point on a certain rigid body of reference, with which that event or object coincides in space. This applies not only to scientific description, but also to everyday life. If I say, for example, that an event occurs at the location, Potsdam Square in Berlin, it specifically means the following. The Earth's surface is the practically rigid body to which the location refers. On this surface, Potsdam Square in Berlin is a particularly marked location with the given name, and the event coincides in space with this particular location. This simple method of specifying a location, however, can only be used with the points on the surface of a rigid body. This method is further limited in that it is dependent on the presence of specifically marked and named places on this surface. Let us see how we can free ourselves from these two limitations, using the sheer power of our imagination, without altering the essential nature of our location specification method. Suppose, for instance, that a cloud is hovering over the Potsdam Square. We can determine its location in the three-dimensional space, in relation to the surface of the Earth, by erecting a pole vertically on the square, so that it reaches up to the cloud. The length of the pole measured with the measuring stick, e.g., the height to the cloud, together with the location of the base point of the pole on the Earth's surface, is then a complete location information of the cloud.